So good morning, everyone. Remember, we have been dealing with interview skills questions, and we've been forming a question bank. It is good to see that most of you have written the questions. Some of you have also written the answers. Now, there are a few things that we need to do. Remember, when we were talking about introduction and when we did our group discussion, we came to know about why time is important. Now, here as well, what happens is if you see the answers that have been written to the questions, not only you and your colleagues, they're just one sentences. Remember, after speaking so many sentences also, we are not able to reach 10, 12 or 15 minutes, okay? So now if you take the question, let me give you a real scenario. In an interview, a minimum of 5 questions would be asked, including your introduction. Now, even if you take 2 minutes per question, it would be just 10 minutes, not more. Now, if you have taken advice from your senior friends who have had an experience of giving an interview, interviews usually tend to last from 15 to 20 minutes, approximately. 15 is a minimum bar which they reach. Now, even if you answer 5 questions, giving 2 minutes each, then also you don't reach the 10-minute mark. And on top of it, if we just have one single sentence as an answer or as a reply, then I don't think it would be not more than 5 or 7 minutes, right? So the first thing that we need to do is we need to reframe our answers in the form of small paragraphs. At least 3 to 4 sentences is what is required. Right? At least 3 to 4 sentences is what is required. Some of you have done it. I'm not saying not everybody has not done it. In some answers, it is there. I can see it. Right? You've written at least 2 or 3 sentences. But what we have to do is we have to reframe the answers, first thing. Second thing, some of you have not written the answer entirely at all, right? So that's also fine. We work it out today because we'll require the sample answer for the candidates to answer. Now, if you see, I've already in the same shared folder, you can now see there's a third sheet which is reflecting the interviewer and the interviewee. Right, the one who's going to take the interview and the one who's going to give the interview. And we are trying to take a real-time experience of things. So first thing that we do, I'm giving you 20 to 25 minutes of time to sort out the answers, reframe them. You may take help from internet, you may take help from other resources, but reframe the answers in the form of a paragraph. Let's say if somebody asks me, there's a question which is not answered and that's why I'm answering it. What is your hobby, right? So what I can answer over here is, see, one of my hobbies is reading. I love to read books. I love to read because reading keeps me updated. I do not read a specific genre, but I also read books related to literature and books related to my field. This is actually tending to become one of my strengths now. Because of my vast and diverse reading, I am able to connect different things in technology. This is more than 3-4 sentences. Okay, you can extend it a little more as well. I hope I'm making myself clear when I'm saying I need 3-4 sentences in the place of every one sentence that you have written as an answer, right? So let's say group 2, they have written that, how did you come to know about this job recruitment? So I came to know about the opening from online listings as well as a job fair. So this is a very generalized idea. We need to be very specific. Say, I was in search of opportunities in my field of study when I came across this advertisement in the Times of India newspaper in the month of August. See, I'm not saying you give a specific date. Sometimes it is okay, we might not remember the specific date, but you need to give a specific resource. So when I came across this job profile, did they really hear when the question is asked like this, how did you come to know about the job recruitment? They really don't want to know how did you come to know. What they actually want to know is, how did you find interest to look into things? And then you want decide or come to a point where you decide you want to apply for this particular job opening. So this one sentence cannot be sufficient to answer this question. I hope I'm making myself clear.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, right. So we're trying to take a real-time experience so that it not only helps you right away, but also will help you in the future. So the first 20 minutes, what I'm giving you to do is, what you can sit and do right away is, you work out the questions. I know you guys have the potential. That I understand. I really have an idea about it, right? So right away in this lab, right now, only 20 minutes I'm giving. It's 9:40, 10 o'clock I'll take a... We'll refresh and we'll look at how you reframe the question. Right away, you start reframing the answers. Right? So I'm giving you 20 minutes of time. This first 20 minutes given to you to reframe the answers. And remember, the order of the panel does not mean you work in that way. I'll tell you who, which panel goes first, which goes second. So don't worry about that part. You can have a look at which candidate is allocated to you. It's a random allocation. Okay? It's a random allocation. What to do next? I'll inform. But first, you start reframing the questions. In between, if you have any doubt, I'm here only. You may always ask me. I think, do we require still a little more time? 10 more minutes? Yes and no can help. I can see there are still few answers that are pending. Right, send 10, 12 minutes more, okay? Excellent. I see you have completed your work. Now let's move on to the actual work that we have to do. This was the pending work which we did, right? Now the actual work. Now, if you see, I have given or allocated candidates. According to the number of panelists in the panel, okay? Panel one, if there are two, then two. If there are four panelists, then there are four candidates that are given. Now, what are we going to do? Let's understand the process. Remember, kindly take it seriously, as if you are actually appearing for, as if you are actually appearing for this interview. So you begin with the greetings, you ask the person to take a seat. Imagine the situation that you are there. Okay, please. So you start with good morning. The person will wish good morning. Please make yourself comfortable or please have a seat. Be seated. And then the candidate says thank you and then it begins. Now there would be a few questions or a few things that we should keep in mind. So first thing, please keep a note and track of things, okay? Because we need this in order. Very first thing that should come to your mind is, madam, how many questions are we supposed to ask to that particular candidate? So per candidate, I'm not saying per everybody, but per one person, per candidate, you are supposed to ask 3 to 5 questions. Just like we do in the mock interview. 3 to 5 questions you are supposed to ask to the candidate, per candidate. Now, madam, only one panelist will ask, or can we ask, everybody will ask one question? Now, if you see the number, it's 3 to 5. So everybody at least gets chance to ask one question to one candidate. Now, there would be one question that will remain common for everybody, every candidate. That question is, introduce yourself. So you don't always say introduce yourself. Would you like to tell us something about yourself? Can you please introduce yourself? We'd like to know more about you. You can frame the question in any way you like, but the very first question that would be asked to any candidate would be the introductory question. Am I clear? Right? Now, remember, the questions that you have formed, you are not limited to ask from only those questions. You are, it's an unlimited option that you have from the entire list, from the entire list. And you may also ask, or you are also given the chance to ask a question out of the blue, which is not in the list. You can ask question found by any panel in the entire list that we have formed, one, and not all the questions, but one or two questions you may also ask, which is not there in the list. Let's say, how do you connect your hobby with your area of education? How does your hobby help you improvise as a computer engineer? Could be a question out of the blue. Could be a question out of the blue. Remember, as I said, when we have discussed interview skills, always the candidate is supposed to expect the unexpected. It will always happen that there would be a one or two questions that would be out of the league. That is a question which is not expected, never expected. Let's say you can ask the candidate that I'll give you a real life situation and you work a solution to it. Right? Right now we are working with ethics. We are taking case studies, real solution. So say, Say that you have developed a very beautiful application for anything that you may decide. You can tell the candidate. Now you are supposed to take funding from me. How will you convince me and negotiate me to fund your project of this mobile application that you have developed? Now, this is a very unexpected question, very open-ended question where the answer could differ from person to person. You are free to do that. But only one time with one candidate. Okay, not all the 5 questions should be out of the blue. Fine. Now you already know who are the candidates that you are going to interview. Now what you are supposed to do right away, I hope you have made the rules clear for the interview. I've made the rules clear. Should I repeat once again? The interview should start.
Clear.
Yeah, clear. You're clear, right? Great. So right away, what you should do is, you know who the candidate is and who you also know who are your group in the panelist. So very first thing that you are supposed to do is, you don't tell the candidates, but you discuss. You are supposed to right away discuss and decide a few questions that you wish to ask to candidate one. You have to discuss it only with your panelist, your group of panelists. Remember, why am I asking you this, to do this activity? I'm asking you to do this activity because I will not allow you to refer to the list when the actual interview takes place. It is supposed to happen as naturally as it happens in the real scenario. So neither you nor the candidates will be allowed to view this set of questions and answers. Right? Now, even in the part of the candidates, I would suggest you may use the answer that has been written over here as a reference, and you are also free. Now, we are free citizens of a free country, right? Democracy. So we are also free to frame the answer in your own way, not necessary to mug up the answer which is there. You may take the answer as a frame or a line or a guidance, and you may frame the answer on your own. But I'll not allow you to look at that particular document. I'll not allow you to look at that particular document on the day of the interview. So right now, what you need to do is, you as a group of panelists, you need to decide that to person one, we will ask this question. Now, apart from that, every time, let's say there are three people in the panel and there are three candidates. So if interviewer one asks an introductory question to candidate one, he would not be able to ask the introductory question to candidate two. Right? You have to sit and decide who asks which question to candidate one, candidate two, and candidate three. That is why we'll sit and prepare for it right away. You discuss amongst your panel, amongst your group of people, that which question will you ask to whom, and who will ask the question. Let's say interviewer one asks to candidate one, introduce yourself. So it would be next the interviewer two's chance to ask the next question. Or let's say interviewer one asks two questions, interviewer two asks three questions. Which are those three? Because I wanted to go in a very smooth manner, as if it is happening in real time. Okay, virtually in real time, as if you have set for the interview and you are giving the interview, wherein you don't have any interruptions. Sometimes, as I said, you can have an out of the blue question, and sometimes along with the flow, you can ask a question. That's fine. Right? So right away, what I'm asking you to do is sit with your panel member or work with your panel member and discuss. What you can do is, you can always go and refer back to, let's say, I'll take panel one because in the order. So it's Darshil and Harshil. Hey, these are the two people who are going to interview. And the people who are going to give the interview are Raj and Sanjay. So let's say Darshil decides, I'll ask the question of introduction to Raj. I'll say, can you please introduce yourself? Now, in the introduction, Raj talks about his hobby as well. So Harshil says that, or Harshil notes that, I will ask him, okay, how do you relate your hobby to your field of education? And then Harshil further asks, have you done any project work? And then Darshil will ask that, where do you see yourself in 5 years? I hope the example makes things clear. Right? I wish you note down, because you know we have been, I've been asking you to make a book for ETC. You call it a rough book or you call it an all-inclusive book, whatever it is. Note down the name of the candidate and who asks which question. Decide the question right away. Right? So I'm giving you 10 minutes of time to decide the question with your panel member and not with the candidate. I know you are very good friends, but if you are a good friend, you want your friend to progress. So keep the questions hidden from the candidates, and that's why we are not doing it online where everybody can see it. You can do it along with your panel member. In your own online group, you can do it, but not where everybody can see it. Okay, note it down. I want you to prepare at least 5 questions that you feel to ask. Not necessary you ask all the 5, a minimum of 3, that is at least 1 question per panelist, per candidate. So 3 questions is a minimum, 5 is the maximum, right? So right away, I'm giving you 10 minutes of time to prepare for this question answer part, right? Kindly prepare the questions. Who will ask which candidate which question? Discuss with your partner. I don't want, oh my God, madam, he asked the question which I was going to ask. Now what will I ask? Right? Work it in that way. 10 minutes of time given to you for that.
Ma'am.
Yes, Gaurav.
Hello. Ma'am, can you repeat this process in a quick manner? Not in a brief, just in a short.
This entire process right now or the interview process?
No. Who gonna right ask now? You?
Okay, right now, what you are supposed to do is you and your panel member, you already know the candidate, right? So what you do is candidate 1, question 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So question 1, who will ask? Gaurav. Question 2, Mitali. Question 3, Mitali. Question 4, Gaurav. Right. Similarly, for both the candidates or all the 3 candidates, you are supposed to shortlist 5 questions and decide that which panelist will ask which question right away. But not in our shared folder. You have to just discuss it. It should be between you and the panel member. That's it.
Okay, ma'am. Got it.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I hope we have been able to complete our work. If not, before the next lab session, kindly complete the work. As I said, it's not necessary panel one goes first. So before your next lab, against the panel name, we'll mention the order. 1, 2, 3, 4, that I'll mention the order in the same file before the panel name. We are not going to go panel one, then panel two. We are not going to go like that. Okay. So that I'll be mentioning, and I'll be making a change in the document. You can have a look at the document by Saturday. There would be a change. The order will be mentioned for you over there. All right. I hope things are clear. Whatever is incomplete, you may complete by the next lab. So before the next lab starts. So by the time you are doing your work, I have already taken the attendance. I'll just post the absent numbers. I'll post the absent numbers. I think these are the absent numbers, right? Fine. We'll end the lab session on this note. Next time, please be prepared. I'll not allow you to go back to this document. Remember, to the question answer part, right? I'll not allow you to go back. So kindly have a question ready with you, which you want to ask to the candidate. Fine. We'll end here on this note. Thank you, class. Have a nice day.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes, Gaurav. Anjan.
Ma'am, Anjan, 50 present.
50 is present. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Just a minute. Just a minute. Fine. Thank you for telling me. I might have missed the name. Okay. Anybody else whom I have missed? No? Right. Kindly inform your friends who are absent about the activity that we are going to do in the next lab session. Fine. Thank you, class. Have a nice day.